there has been an increase in patients with substance use disorders, making the need for rehabilitation, you know, like this one, all the more pressing. The government is taking big steps to root out this problem, whether wherever it exists, because while recovery is immensely important, prevention is the key. The truth is, we would much prefer to invest our dollars in ensuring no child ever has exposure to hard drugs in the first place, taking a proactive approach rather than a reactive one. That's why, with the help of the international partners like Australia and Korea and New Zealand, we're taking bold action to better patrol our areas with a mission to stop the flow of illegal drugs through our country as they move on to their intended markets in Australia, New Zealand, and of course beyond. Through a dedicated fleet of ships and highly trained staff, we are dedicated to curbing trafficking from foreign countries into Fiji. Meanwhile, I encourage Fijian parents to do their part in this critical fight. Set a good example for your children. Help them find happiness and fulfillment in other ways, and give them the emotional support that they need, to choose a path that is free of substance abuse. Talk to them openly at a young age about the dangers of drugs and alcohol, and guide them to a future that is free of addiction and dependency. I've heard it said that it takes a whole village to raise a successful child. Well, it will take our entire nation to come together to give every Fijian man, woman, and child the chance to live free from exposure to hard drugs. To every friend and neighbor out there working to keep our streets clean from these deadly substances, you have in my government and in the Fiji Police Force. We're very keen to pursue the community-based partnerships that are critical to keeping our nation safe from harm. From prevention to education to rehabilitation, we must continue to address substance use disorders and all psychiatric conditions from all sides. By doing so, we can enter a new age of mental health care in Fiji. And every Fijian can take part in this path forward simply by offering a shoulder to lean on when we see our brothers and sisters being led astray. Alcohol and self-harm are all forms of misguided self-medication that the mentally unwell turn to when they are not living a fulfilling life. But instead of turning to substance abuse, those suffering with mental health and addiction need a support system they can turn to. Across all income brackets and backgrounds, from successful professionals to seemingly happy students, we see this as a plague on our society. Our misguided moral compass pointing them to an unhealthy and unfulfilling future. They're actively looking for warning signs and openly asking if they need help. Friends and loved ones can fix that compass, and we can fill that void. I propose that we pledge to do